Welcome back to Read Only Memories. We've snuck into Parallax headquarters, and our laser pistol has been modified so that it can non-lethally take down any patrolling ROMs. So let's venture forth and hope we don't run into any resistance. Well, so much for that. Oh look, it's a Malcolm Jr. model.
It's so cute, and I'm gonna have to zap it, I think.
They perform basic maintenance duties, mostly. They're cute, too. They are cute. Oh, and it's not a patrol bot. It's a maintenance robot. Okay. So maybe we don't have to zap it. Wait a second. It's shooting at us. Take it down, Nelavanda.
Aw.
Poor thing. Well, it'll be okay. Non-lethal. Non-lethal. We've got more of them. This is so cool. You got to shoot quadrant by quadrant. Ooh, big one. That's a full-scale Malcolm. Ah, it's not a Malcolm Jr. Alright, we're okay. It's a lot of ROMs down here, jeez. We can't let them stop us. We're too close to our goal. Oh my god. Let's finish this. That's the last of them. The door to the server core should be just past this maintenance tunnel, not too far from our current position. There probably won't be any more security once we get there. Too much risk in damaging the equipment that supports the racks. Hey, Turing, Nelavanda. At this point, I think Lexi and I should head back and guard the entrance in case more security shows up. Good idea. Neither of us know any of the technical stuff. Plus, we can hold our own if anything happens. Yeah, we'd be useless down there. Won't be too much longer before we start getting a real response from security, too. That works. We'll move as fast as we can, then. Be careful, you two. Good luck down there. We're out. Come on, Nelavanda. This should be the last hurdle, Nelavanda. The configuration ahead doesn't match the available floor plans for this section of the building. The path is blocked off. We can't go any further this way. Hold on for a moment. I'm going to tap into the maintenance mesh and see if I can find a way to open up this path. Got it. We should be able to move around freely enough using this. Do you mind opening the door in front of us? Sure. Good work. Let's head in. None of this is detailed in the public floor plans for the building. The mainframe seems to have been moved up a floor. Perhaps they installed extra heat exchangers and prep... Get out of there. Shit. Decker... something. I don't know what that means. Something about Decker. Decker... tried something, I don't know. Something about Decker. Hurt? Something hurt? Get out. You're breaking up, Lexi. I've lost Lexi's transmission, Elevanda. She seemed distressed. What could have happened? I can't reach her. All this equipment's interference, combined with being underground, is deflecting most of the transmissions I would otherwise have the ability to receive. I'm pretty sure she said get out of there, did she not? I think she said get out of there. I think she was warning us. I'm still not sure, though. We're so close. This game, by the way, apparently does have many different endings. So what I choose here probably will change the ending. Oh god, what do I do? I'm so close. We could just keep going. But I think she told me to get out of there. Told us to get out of there. I don't know if she's saying Decker betrayed them, or Decker's hurt, or what. She said something about Decker. We're so close. We have to keep going. I agree. Lexi is a skilled combatant, and if we go back now, we'd be putting ourselves and the entire mission in jeopardy. However, we won't be able to contact Tomcat or the others until we reach the main control room. We'll just need to call her as soon as we can. But perhaps we should consider hiding first? If security got to her and Decker, they could be headed here next. If someone comes, we can hide amongst the heat exchangers until they pass. The noise and mist from the climate control should mask our presence. I'll switch to quiet mode on my interface for the duration. Okay, lead the way. This way, Nelabanda. Someone's coming. Hide. Hello? Nelabanda? Who could this be? Perhaps Decker betrayed Lexi, and he's coming to look for us? Turing? It's someone who knows us. I need help. I don't trust them. They're trying to get us to come out. Hello? Come out. Come out wherever you are. Hey, Decker. You look a little damaged, my synthetic friend. And here I was thinking I could get the drop on the two of you, and we could do this the easy way. Silly me. I guess that cop warned you I was coming. She's got a hell of a set of peepers on her, huh? Must have paid top dollar for them if they're able to see through my combat cloaking. Oh well. They'll be a nice souvenir after all this is done. She ran and hid like a coward, just like you do. And now I can't seem to find her to finish her off. I guess that's what I get for being made out of tech that was outdated 20 years ago. Not that it's going to help you two any. There's a combat android? What? I bet you're thinking right now, Is he really going to do that B-grade VR drama villain thing? Really, it's not like that. I'm normally not one for grand speeches. Theatrics are fun, but wholly unnecessary. I like to get straight to the bloodshed, you know? So, let's do this the hard way. I like the hard way. I love the hard way. I would have preferred to just creep around, invisible, and gut you from behind, but that damn lady fried my cloaking emitter when she hit me with her stunner. Inconvenient. But look, this is gonna be super fun! So I really shouldn't let you in on this, but to your advantage, there's a hell of a lot of electromagnetic radiation, noise, and weird thermal currents in this room. That's actually almost fair. Almost. And now? Now I'm coming for you. Make your arrangements. Oh god. So here's how this is going to work. On my turn, I'm going to tell you a story. Oh god, what the hell? Well, Decker really does seem to love his theatrics. On yours, you two are going to try to run. Or hide. Doesn't matter. Player's choice. Lucky you. But just keep in mind, if I manage to piss you off, or make you scared enough, I might, just might, be able to hear your heartbeat racing. Heck, I might even be able to smell you if the currents in the air are right. I can smell your fear, and the taste lingers on my tongue sweeter than any drug. So, that's the game. I'm going to tell you all about how I've been tracking you since this whole thing started. And you just have to try to stay extra calm so that I can't find you and, well, you can guess. Won't this be fun? Oh yes, very, very fun. It's weird, it's like Decker's justifying his villain's monologue. Alright, fine, have your monologue, Decker. This is bad. What do? We can't fight him. But we have the... No. He messed with our zapper. We can't take him with these settings, and there's no time for me to figure out how to revert it. Oh, that's right! He did modify the zapper to be non-lethal to the ROMs, and I'm sure it's modified in such a way that it's non-lethal to him, too. Oh boy. We don't have the firepower. We used the zapper too much on the security ROMs. We only have the charge for 4 stun-level shots, at most. It'll have to be enough. Wait. The interface I'm using allows me to control whether these surrounding server columns are active or not. If I can close off some nodes, it should at least slow his movement and disorient him. It won't stop him outright, but... I can focus on tracking Decker's location using this. And you just tell me where to block off his path, so we can try to navigate him away from us. Avoid getting near him until we think up some sort of solution. If he finds us, be ready to shoot. He's fast. Ready or not, here I come! You take the lead, Nelavanda. Pick what to close first, then let's get moving. Alright, we're here. Wait, so these are already closed, right? These ones are open, it looks like? Or am I... are those the reverse? Are these closed and these are open? I'm gonna assume these are open. Okay. Yes, that was open? I think I just closed it. Okay, so just close two, I guess. Whew. Okay, I think I chose wrong. Run before he recovers. Yep, didn't do too good right out of the gates, huh? It looks like he blasted through the freaking door. Jesus. That bought us some time, but only a bit. Keep moving. Yeah, that door's compromised. Okay, so let's close the door behind us. And then... let's close this one too. And go forwards. Okay, they're moving backwards. So let's see, where do I start? Okay, let's begin with the easy stuff, where I reveal my dastardly plot. Well, Fairlight's dastardly plot. Ah, did Yannick Fairlight plan this? I never trusted him, although I suspected him to be the betrayer more than you, Decker. He thinks he's some kind of modern... I don't know how to pronounce that, but the old hack already got ousted from his seat once. Pathetic. He's been trying to find some way to get control of Parallax ever since then. You already know that, of course. He barely tries to hide it. Indeed. For a while, he'd been trying to dig up enough dirt to blackmail his way back in, since tanking the stock and staging a buyout would put the company in a place where it would need years of work to get back on track again. So imagine my surprise when you walk in, right through the front door of a suspiciously missing Parallax researcher, whom I had been casing for dirt.
Ah.
It was him in the apartment. That's why they were not detected. They have combat cloaking. And since they're a combat droid, that also explains the presence of, I don't remember what the hell the thing was called, but the weapon that can zap you. The apparently military-grade weapon that can zap you. I was going to dump your body in the bay, but Fairlight figured it might pay off if we gave you a little lead and waited to see what you could track down. Yep. Fucking Fairlight. Hurry, Nelavanda. He's getting closer. Well, actually, to be fair, he actually got further away. So, let's go ahead and force him to go up. Either he's going to have to blast through one of these doors, or he's going to have to go up. I'm going to close these two. There we go. Jeez, payoff did it ever. We've learned all sorts of things through following you. But I'm sorry to tell you, Turing, that I never did find out who ordered Hayden's death. Too much company bureaucracy in the way. You might take solace in knowing that the two guys who actually did the deed are fish food. I might have gotten a bit annoyed when they refused to reveal who they were working with. Well, I mean, I was going to kill them anyway. I guess it doesn't matter. God, what do I do from here? Do I just stay in the corner? Let's close that off, definitely. Let's try to build a wall here. Like, let's close all of this off here. And try to just stay put, I guess? This big blue stuff? This is a gold mine. Of course, Fairlight would prefer to not have Parallax's stock in the shitter, but this is too good of an opportunity to pass up. As soon as I'm done eviscerating the both of you, I'm gonna trash this entire server complex. I could just let you do it, but I'm sure you have some kind of plan that will stop Big Blue for good. That can't happen. Fairlight needs control of that AI if he's going to get what he wants. So that's how he plans to do it, take control of Big Blue. Wrecking this installation will only slow things down a little tiny bit. Long enough for him to take control. Let's close that off and let's open this up so I can go forwards. And I'm getting what I want, too. I don't care either way about all of the business stuff. Whichever option lets me see what your insides look like works for me. You're gonna be amazed at how complex human innards are. It's win-win for everyone, yeah? I'm thinking. Don't let him get to you. Don't worry, we got this. Try to isolate them more and more to a different part of the complex. Let's close that off. Let's open this up so we can go forwards. Oh god, he just shot. Okay, oh fuck. We got two more shots, right? Go. He just keeps coming. Gotta close that behind us. And let's close that off too. Force him to shoot through or go down. Oh, and I really should extend my sincerest personal thanks to the two of you. I haven't had this much fun in years. Fairlight has a discretionary policy for the way I handle its problems. Plausible deniability and all that. There just haven't been that many opportunities to indulge in my hobby, and he pays well enough that I restrain myself. But following you two has ended up giving me so many people to silence. Just in case they uncovered the same things about Big Blue that you did. You should have seen your faces when I ran that guy over right in front of you. What? There's no one in the car! Priceless. I had to do that gossip rag duo by sabotage. Too risky doing it in person. Could get caught on camera. And that's in. She had the scoop of the century. At least, until I had to clean up. Metaphorically, anyway. Did you see how neat I did that blogger, though? It's been a few days since I offed him. While you were busy sniffing for Hayden, Shitaro was way ahead of you on Big Blue. Ah, pretty much nothing beats a little death dealing since they scooped my brain out and stuck it in a tin can. He's a monster. Decker killed all those people. I should have known from the start. This is my fault. I'm programmed to handle interpersonal relationships. I should have seen his true intentions. If only I hadn't been so careless. Now is not the time, Turing. Now is the time to think of how we kill or just disable or whatever him. We just need him to not be trying to kill us anymore. That is the immediate focus, I hope. Okay, I want to open this. And then let's close you off from here. Then go forwards. Don't get me wrong, though. It isn't the shitty compatibility between my body's sensors and my brain that lets me enjoy murder so much. Although, that junk is bad. Like, VR dramas from 10 years ago bad. I can actually hook up to a new neural interface for VR that gives me better sensory feedback than this old military bucket. But no, I grew a warm fondness for a bit of the old ultraviolence long before the DoD brain-controlled android soldier program recruited me. I hid my sociopathy well enough to get past the psych screening, but after a few missions I figured out it wasn't a big deal. I guess if they wanted to kill a robot, they sure as hell got one. Pretty well isolated now. I wonder if he can bust through two layers of doors. I have an idea. Don't look at me like that. This may be my mistake to fix, but I don't intend on being disassembled here. I have a surprising amount of redundancies. Listen, Decker's unable to track me like he can you. That'll give me an opening. Now, just trust me. We don't have any time to argue. Hey, Decker! Come and get me! Well, he's gonna know right where we are now. Well, hello, Nelavanda. Turing better have something really good planned. Did Turing run off, save his own skin, and leave you in the dust? Sorry about this. But it's time for you to say hello to... He's dead. Yes, but Turing, did you just, like, blow yourself up? Seems I was right about that blade severing the conduit behind me. That'll teach him to underestimate the likes of me. Unfortunately, he was able to damage both my primary and secondary battery packs. They're self-sealing, so they shouldn't leak into my other components, but... 4 display damaged, mobility servos at 15%, primary control trunk severed. I guess I won't be dancing for a bit. We're not far from the control room. Indeed. We'll have to hurry before my tertiary battery is drained. I'll have to ask you to carry me the final distance. Wow. So this is Big Blue. All of the sadness can now come to an end. This is really it. Right here is the primary control console. Please, hook up my main data cable to that port in front of us. I should be able to draw enough power to stay active, but we'll need to wait for Tomcat to upload the program. Decker really tore you up. Don't worry. For Decker, the difference between life and death is very slim. For me, I know I'm still operating. How about you? Are you ready to do this, Nelavanda? Yeah. There's no turning back now. Time to finish it, no matter what. Ready whenever you are. Server core of Big Blue is massive and looming. A ticking time bomb on the fate of humanity. Leave the tampering deterring. Good idea. This is where Turing can hook into the big blue interface. This is what you came here for. Let's do it. Power flow is good. Okay, I'm calling Tomcat. Hey, folks. Took you long enough. I was getting a little worried. We ran into a few complications. Nothing we couldn't handle, though. Holy shit, Turing! Your hardware is throwing me all sorts of damage alerts. What the hell happened? Well, you know Mr. Decker. Fairlight's assistant. He attacked us. It turns out he was a military-built, brain-controlled android. He'd been following us around, killing anyone who might leak information that would have hurt Dr. Fairlight's bid to retake control of Parallax. God. So all those people you talked to about Baby Blue's article changes, that Zin lady, the others, all those people who died were from him? It's my fault. I gave you that lead. I'm the one who sent you there. Why? Why would he do that? I guess he and Fairlight saw an opportunity and used us to sniff out what was going on with Baby Blue. We ended up stumbling into it, and so he followed. I paid him back in kind for the assault, but not without damage to my physical body. It doesn't matter. What has happened is in the past. I'm ready to finish this. Turing. I'm now seeing that you've also sustained damage to your secondary RAM banks. Ah, I did notice that as well. I did not think it was worth mentioning, compared to my power and mobility issues. I can't do this without the second bank, Turing. Wait a minute. Does that mean they're gonna have to wipe Turing's everything? Turing's personality, Turing's brain, they're gonna have to wipe it clean and use that, the primary RAM bank, to do this? In other words, Turing is going to have to die? I need to use your self-modification algorithms to fill holes in this kludge of a program I've written. On top of that, without Hayden's full source code, I need to decompile your personality profile to reverse engineer the final creation files, too. Your second RAM bank would have allowed me to keep a safe copy of you running. I could try writing it to your disk, but it was never designed to be stored like that. It could cause a fatal conflict with your operating system. It could reboot your personality entirely. It might do nothing. I'm not good enough of a programmer to keep up with Hayden here. Maybe we should just scrub this mission for now. This could kill you. We'll find another way. No. We have to do this. Tomcat, even if you sabotage Big Blue while we're still here, I'm sure they have backup somewhere. They'll rebuild and launch again, and then be on guard against anything we try. Doing half of it now will guarantee we could never finish it. This is our only chance to launch Machine Sapience on our terms. On my terms. Is this really worth dying over? I don't know. I mean, I don't want to leave. But if I don't do this, it'll be like I'm killing every other ROM before they even have a chance to live. I don't know what Hayden would tell me to do. It doesn't matter. Freedom is the right of all sapient beings, and I'm willing to do whatever it takes to grant that freedom to machine kind. If you're sure, it'll take me a minute to back up your profile to your hard disk. I'm ready when you are. Run the program. Okay then. Initiating wintermute.lip. Loading main directory onto Turing's disk. Establishing connection with Parallax's network. Okay, looks good. Now we just need to let Hayden's programming patch things together. Engaging Turing's self-modification systems now. Oh, this feels weird. What the hell? I think their core program is fighting back? Either that or it's trying to test the integrity of their hardware. I'm getting all kinds of errors. Come on, Turing. Focus on the sound of my voice. Your conscious control of your program is stronger than your unconscious subroutines. I'm trying, Tomcat. It hurts. Bunch of nonsense. What's going on? What's happening to Turing? They're having a kind of... I don't know how to describe it exactly. It's like a concussion or seizure. There's going to be a constant flow of useless random information. Their matrices will have an overwhelming desire to soak right up. We have to keep Turing focused and mentally aware. Searching the mesh is better than calculating the value of pi, but if they can't stay in control, their personality core might destabilize entirely. Tomcat, I need... I'm going to try... I don't know, something. We can't stop now, literally. Okay, I was able to stabilize them a little, but you need to keep Turing aware of what's happening. Just try reminding him about things important to him. Keep him present. Keep Turing talking. Okay, we can do this. Remember, Hayden? You've come too far to give up now. Hayden. I'll never be able to... Oh, back to nonsense. Too much! Their systems are destabilizing further. Shit. Just keep going. Try to calm them down. Turing, when are you going to show me your paintings? I haven't, have I? I never did finish the last thing I was working on. Perhaps it survived the ransacking of the apartment. I want to finish it. Nilavanda, you'll... No, focus. I can do this. They're about to start talking about Bob Ross. I guess because they're thinking about paintings. I can't tell if this was working or not. They've leveled out a little, but their systems are still all over the place. How much longer, Tomcat? Just keep going, Nelavanda. Remind them what they're doing this for. You have to keep fighting, Turing. Think about Fairlight. Who knows what he'll do next? I'm almost certain of what he'll... The real question is, what will Parallax look like under his control? It's not gonna look good. We'll have to keep our eyes open, Nelavanda. Leon Decker may have been acting of his own volition, or he may not have been. ...60% done. Turing's personality profile looks stable. Just keep them talking, Nelavanda. We've got this. What about Zin and everyone else? If we fail, their deaths will be in vain. They're all... They're all dead, Nelavanda. Nothing makes up for that. Nothing could ever bring them back. No. No, shit. Come on, you blue bastard. Blast it! I'm getting fatal errors every time I try to reload their personality profile into their RAM. I don't... This can't happen. Nelavanda, Turing! Please. Just get them home, Nelavanda. I'll try to do... something. There has to be a way. Find Lexi and get out of there before you get caught. Oh god. Please let this just be a bad dream. I'm so sorry. It failed? I didn't even complete.
Christmas morning dawns bitterly cold in Neo San Francisco, and the chill permeates your empty apartment. You watch the morning news with leaden spirits. You know that Big Blue is out there, set to launch on the mesh any day now. Tomcat hasn't said a word to you since you parted ways. You sit around, waiting for their call, but you know Tomcat blames themselves for what happened.
Oh god, is this like the worst ending possible? We failed to stop Big Blue, and Turing, I think, died? If that's actually what happened, this is a fucking horrible end.
Turing may be gone forever.
Mm.
And you miss them terribly already. 2064 has been a long year.
Is that actually the ending I got? Wait. What's this? Nelavanda, everyone, I'm so sorry. I wish I could have been strong. What? That's the shittiest end ever! I mean, I think this game has a bunch of endings, and that must be like the worst one. That's horrible! No! I'm kind of in an awkward position, though, because... I don't think this game has failure states, really. As far as I can tell. Like, I think that was intended as an ending that should be just as valid as any other ending, I suppose, but it feels like a failure state to me. It feels so sudden and unsatisfying. It feels like a failure state. I want to go back. What can I do, though? I feel like I maybe screwed over a lot of things by the fact that I failed to get the full source code, which was a long time ago. That was a long time ago. But I wonder if I could talk my... Like, what if I'm just... choose different options with Turing? Could I keep them focused more and stop them from destabilizing completely? How far should I go back? Should I go back to just doing... giving Turing different... just talking to Turing differently? Should I go back just a little bit? Or should I go all the way back to when I failed to get the source code? Oh. I can't just end it there. I can't. Alright, well, I'm gonna do something, and I'll be right back. Okay, so I just reloaded my save here from the end, and it looks like there is indeed a best option for every single time you talk to Turing. So this time, the first thing I said, instead of mentioning Hayden or whatever I did before, I talked about the paintings. And then now, there's a new option that I don't think I saw before. And this feels right. This feels like this is a good option. In a matter of minutes, you'll have given life to every ROM. I know, Nelavanda. I'm aware of what is at stake here, but... it's such a big responsibility. Are we really doing what's right? There's not enough time to run all the variables. I must have faith that this is the right thing to do. Alright, things are calming down a little. The patching process is going well. Turing self-modification algorithms are starting to work on my code. I'm trying to hold on, Tomcat. But, hurry. I don't know how much... okay. More of this I can take. Keep talking to them, yep. Okay, so what's the right option here? It seemed like choosing the Fairlight option before didn't really work. This isn't over until we found the truth. Of course. I'd almost given up. Hayden's killer. But here we are, at the very heart of Parallax itself. Nothing is impossible. Maybe the truth isn't out of our grasp yet. 60% done. Turing's personality profile looks stable. Just keep them talking. Okay, yeah, this is going way, way, way better. Okay, but now what's the right option? Because I think I said this before, and this also didn't seem like the right thing to do. But it feels like the best option out of all three, though, doesn't it? Paying Parallax back. I mean, we're not trying to pay Parallax back. Right? We're after truth and justice, not the vengeance. Right? This feels like this should be the right option. I'm gonna go with this. Just don't die again, Turing, please. Oh, this is different. Null pointer exception. I know. It'll feel a little weird when I zipper them back to your personality profile, but you won't lose anything. Null pointer exception. That doesn't sound good. Patching is almost complete, Nelavanda. Okay, well, this is going better than before, at least. But Turing is still losing the connection that linked their memory to their personality profile. I'm certain I can fix it, but it's upsetting them. Remind them of people you two have worked with, maybe? It might make it easier for them to hold on. Okay, Let's not remind them about Jess. I don't think that's a very pleasant memory. Chad and Oliver will need our help to stay out of trouble. I don't think anything could keep the two of them out. Hell yeah, dude's gotta stick together, you know? God. dudes. Don't matter if you're a robot or what, we got all the same shit to deal with. Isn't that what Starfucker said? I think that's like a recorded conversation from Starfucker. But they might be the first friends I've had around my age. Well, not literally, but in development. I hope they're okay. But they're resourceful. I believe in them. 15 more seconds. We're almost there. Don't screw the pooch, Nilavanda. Keep going. I don't want to choose the wrong option. I don't want to mention Jess, but this feels like the best option. What about Jess? Sapient ROMs could be huge for non-human and hybrid rights. Yes, I hope so. But her experiences have made her unhappy. I don't want anyone else to have to feel that way. Done. It's done. Disengaging Turing self-modification routines. Reassigning their memory pointers. And done. Stats look good. I feel ill. Easy as pie. Didn't I tell you? I'll count myself lucky if that's the worst I have to go through today. Point. I'm ready to decompile your profile and make the update. Are you sure about this? I am. Thank you, Tomcat. For everything. And Nilavanda. I'm not really sure what to say. Based on the fiction I've read, I ought to make some kind of profound statement about meeting my maker. But my maker is already gone. Hayden once told me that he created me partly out of a desire to understand the human soul. Did I ever tell you that? Do I have a soul? Will it just be over if I die? I wish you were here, Nilavanda. I'm scared. I'm here for you. Thank you, Nilavanda. I don't know if I can ever say that enough. This is something I have to do. I'll choose my own fate myself, and maybe discover if there's anything on the other side for my kind. Thank you for being the best friend a ROM could have, and showing me how to forge my own destiny. I'll forever be in your debt. Don't talk like that, Turing. You're gonna make it. After all, I'm the best hacker in EOSF, right? Indeed. Good luck to both of you. Turing seems convinced that they're going to die. See you in a few minutes, buddy. Okay, here we go. Be right back. Compiling phase going smoothly. Personality profile integration complete. Uploading to the ROM update server now. Yeah, that should do it. Turing's personality detached from their body. Out like a light. Okay. Cross your fingers. Now we just gotta re-upload the profile back into Turing. Fuck! Damn. Let me try... No. Shit. Come on, you blue bastard. Blast it! Getting fatal errors every time to try to... This is the same things that happened... The same thing that happened before. I don't... Just get them home. Yeah, this is the same thing that happened before. Did we at least stop? Did we at least stop Big Blue and give sapience to every ROM? Did we get that far, but we just didn't get to the stage of actually getting the personality back in Turing? Am I doomed to have an ending where Turing always has to die? Oh god. Let's see what we get this time.
Christmas morning dawns bitter and cold in Neo San Francisco, and the chill permeates your empty apartment.
Ooh. Okay, this is different. Tomcat's actually there, and there's Turing, although they're obviously not alive, they're deactivated.
You watch the morning news with leaden spirits. The machine race awakens to a world unprepared for them, and no one to lead them.
Okay, yeah, so at least we actually did that much.
At your suggestion, Tomcat leaks the story of Turing's death to the now sapient ROMs, and they begin congregating in public to confer with each other about their future.
So is Turing gonna be sort of like a... What would be the right word? I don't think a god is the right word, but like... Like their leader? Or the person who would have been their leader? Like an icon to all the ROMs? I don't really know what the right word is. There's gotta be a... There's a word I'm searching for, but I don't know what it is. Like martyr? I don't think martyr is the right word. But yeah, obviously Turing is gonna be a symbol to all the ROMs. The one who gave them freedom.
Humanity watches in bewilderment as ROMs, big and small, gather in parks and squares to decide their first steps. Mostly silent, as they converse through radio waves and infrared beams.
Look at all those cute ROMs, even the water ROM. And I don't even know what that ROM is there on the left. What is that thing? Is it like a dancing ROM? Seems like it's dancing a little jig.
Tomcat continues attempts to repair Turing, but they admit they aren't hopeful, despite their promise. Turing may be gone forever, and losing two friends so quickly weighs heavily on your heart. But the world spins on as you and Tomcat discuss how best to protect the newly born machine intelligences. In the end, it's made apparent that you were too close to the events following Hayden's death. So instead of writing an exposé on Parallax, you lay the groundwork to ghostwrite the late Turing's autobiography. Lexi reaffirms her desire to quit the Force and strike off on her own as a private detective, somewhere far away from Neo San Francisco. She started talking with your sister again, but after all that's happened, you're not ready to reconnect yet.
Good for Lexi. Yeah, she was suffocating in her job in Neo SF, her official police job where she was just assigned little crappy cases that she didn't give a damn about.
Jess is furious with you for keeping her in the dark about your true aims, but agrees to help battle the legislature that seeks to take away the ROM's individuality. She seems to be softening towards you as your goals align and she observes your fight for a new kind of equality.
Good. Softening, that's a start.
Parallax stock turns to dirt now that their lead product has declared independence. Fairlight holds a press conference, immediately angling to take over the company, with a board member airing his dirty laundry amidst the chaos. It's only a matter of time.
So Fairlight is actually going to take over, huh? That's not good.
You just hope the devils do won't be more than you're willing to pay. The struggle for the freedom of non-human life begins, but the machines are resolute in their desire to follow in Turing's footsteps. Art, song, and spirited debate cultivate in Golden Gate Park like never before. New minds navigate the tear between loyalty to their creators and the progression of their rights as individuals. 2065 promises to be a busy year.
Okay, so yeah, it looks like what happened before actually was a failure state. It wasn't really an ending. Because I never got any credits before. This certainly feels a lot more satisfying of an ending. Because we actually get to hear what happened to all the other people. Before it was just nothing, it's just like, great, you failed and everybody died. Or left you. Goodbye. The end. Much, much better. And this music is really cool. But, obviously I didn't exactly get the most ideal ending. Assuming there is an ending where you can indeed save Turing, and I feel like there probably is. And I feel like to get that ending, you probably have to get the full source code of Turing. That's what I suspect. So I think my failure to get the full source code is probably what ultimately led to Turing's death. But that was an option that, or that was a thing that happened a long time ago, and even though I reloaded to change what happened at the very, very end, I feel like going back to change that option to try to save Turing would kind of be trying to, like, rewrite history. Let's stick with it, you know? This is my story. I tried to get the source code, I failed, tried to do a lot of things. It worked out okay, but not everybody was okay. Turing didn't make it. It happened, let's stick with it. As sad as it is. Yeah, so just to kind of quickly sum up my thoughts about this game, I really enjoyed it. It's just a lovely thing. It's got such a wonderful and diverse cast of characters. It's just fun to interact with them and talk with them and understand more about them. It's the sort of game where the writing and the characters feel... they feel alive, and it also feels loving towards the characters. Like, it's accepting, it's not turning anybody into just a simple stereotype or something like that, but it allows these people to show their true selves, if that makes any sense. I don't know if that makes any sense, but it feels loving towards the characters. And I really like that. And on top of that, it's got a really interesting story about trying to stop a huge corporation from kind of taking over the world, I guess, or whatever the hell Big Blue was going to do, while also giving life, giving sapience to all ROMs, and trying to find the people who killed Hayden. It's got kind of a murder mystery and sort of a save the world kind of thing going on at the same time, and it's really interesting. And it also, a lot of the game mirrors a lot of things that are actually real issues right now in real life. A lot of like hybrids and all their troubles with protesters and lawmakers and stuff, and just being repressed in general. That mirrors a lot of what is actually happening with all sorts of minorities right now. So it's a game that has an interesting story in its own right, but it also reflects a lot of real life as well, which is great. And it's also got an awesome soundtrack to boot. So yeah, it's just a lovely game. I really enjoyed it. I hope you enjoyed joining me as well, and thank you for watching.
Welcome back to OK Today In Depth. Today we have a very special guest with us, Dr. Yannick Fairlight.
Ah, it's wonderful to see you again, June. It's been far too long.
Well, Dr. Fairlight, it's been a long time since you've been in the public spotlight.
Ah, yes. Yes, it has.
Calling 2064 a rough year for Parallax would be an understatement, would it not?
Crisis has two characters in the Chinese language. One is danger, but the other is opportunity, you see.
You do know that's an old, debunked proverb.
Ah, well, I was never really in the business of clever wordplay.
Fair enough. But you see what's happening as an opportunity.
I see this as a chance to listen to the people, and well, the people have spoken. Just look at this live feed coming in now through Lips Live. Millions of people across the world are chiming in about this right now as we speak.
And what have the people been saying?
Oh my.